I decided to do a little provocation. I think I'm the last one also today. So I decided to do a little provocation on how we are building this startup ecosystem in Brazil. There's an old joke that I'm going to copy, but I think it totally applies to us, is that the startup ecosystem is kind of a Gisele Bündchen, but with 12 years old. We all know she's going to be fantastic, but she's not there yet, right? So I wanted to discuss a little bit 10 things that we should understand better about ourselves, entrepreneurs, so we get better and better and better, and we really become Gisele Bündchen in a while. Before I get that, I have two quick videos that I just wanted to show. Can you help me there? Just need to click here on the corner. No, here. Put the mouse here, kind of here. Yeah. You guys have seen that, right? No?
Yeah! Now I'm in the blogosphere, now I'm in the Twitterverse. Fans get so immersed, but I'm a nerd forever. I'm the new Zuckerberg, and since my website, I've been cooking dough like a chef serving kilobytes. Used to be the basement, back at my mom's place. Building web traffic so that we could sell an ad space. Make way for the one-man businesses. Bailouts finished with white-collar criminals. New Sega Genesis, entrepreneur. Time making big plans to dominate the online. Yeah, I'm on YouTube. This is one man sharing Google revenue with songs on my webcam. Science is the new art, databases day to day. Geek spreading cheat smarts, hustle make the data pay. I could be a Valley Wag plus Geekology. Tell from my avatar that I'm most definitely
So we think we're this, right? But we're not. We're this. a group, a collective that does 2 minutes videos of everywhere. They don't decide the images. They look for the images that are more shared, virals. You know, people are watching more on YouTube. So that totally defines us. You know, even if we're not on the video, we're watching this. Okay, so based on that first conclusion, I wanted to raise 5 things or maybe 10 things that refer to Brazilian startup entrepreneurs. My first question is, are we innovative? And my answer, my point of view, that's totally personal, is no, we are creative. And that's very different. We lack of methodology. We lack of organization. We suffer to transform creativity into innovation. That is adding methodology, is adding persistency. The second thing is, are we disruptive? No, we're copycatters. That's a colonial country, and we still do that majorly. Are there exceptions? Yes, we just saw a few today. But in general, we are copycatters, and that's fine, but we need to admit we are copycatters, like the girl just told us here in the previous debate, and that's totally fine, because there's talent to perform a copycat in another country. You have to be good, you have to adapt, you have to perform, you have to execute. That's no problem, but you can't pretend like I receive 2 emails a week, say, I had an idea, I was looking on the web, and I wanted to create this and that. Say, come on, this is not having an idea, this is copying. The third thing, we're not serious. Oh, come on, you know, this is ridiculous. We're just easygoing. We work very hard, we're just easygoing. I'm tired of those gringos coming to Brazil and posting those things, say, why I hate to work in Brazil, we're always late. Fuck off, get out of here. Yeah, we're just relaxed. You know? Are we optimists? Oh my God, we're super optimists, right? We all will conquer the world, and it's going to be easy, and it's going to be fantastic, and we're going to celebrate a lot. And that's something very important to understand when you're talking to a Brazilian entrepreneur. We are like that, because we are like that as people, right? We had some protests and riots last year in June. But that, you know, even the monster is back sleeping, right? Because why? We're optimists. We still think things will get better. And we take life this way. That's why I'm saying we're easygoing. And that's very bad? Not necessarily. Could be in sometimes, could be very good in others. It's just to understand and live it. And the fifth one, are we visionary? No, we're survivors. That includes some visionary moments, includes some visionary ideas. Yes, but basically, we're survivors. You know, we know what it is to live in a crisis or several different crises. We are very creative to get out of crisis. We don't get desperate when things get bad. You know, we don't kill ourselves when there's a crisis. Other people do, because we're survivors, we're easygoing, and we have all those characteristics. So in a big summary, and I don't want to be too long, right? And that's totally my personal opinion. Being creative, copycatters, easygoing, super optimists, and survivors are not good or bad things. They're just strong characteristic of Brazilians, and consequently, Brazilian entrepreneurs also. And the more we entrepreneurs understand that, the better, because we're not get illuded that we're always presenting something that is a realistic view. If you meet an entrepreneur in Brazil and you ask about the different scenarios, the optimistic, the realistic, and the pessimistic, it's very, very, very rare that the pessimistic scenario represents a big loss. It's going to be like break even. Probably, oh, this, we didn't make it, but still we're going to be break even. And then the realistic will be a few millions in profit, and the optimist will be, you know, hundreds of millions in profit. That's what we are. And that's totally fine when we understand those things. And one thing that is important, I think, is, and it's interesting, this kind of events that are very international, that's being spread out through video worldwide, is not I'm saying this column is good and this column is bad. No, forget about that. That's very old. I'm saying that these are some characteristics of Brazilians and Brazilians entrepreneurs. So international entrepreneurs that want to partner with us, or international investors that want to play in this ecosystem, just to understand a little bit of that. And I could do the same presentation for American entrepreneurs, and it will be a little bit different. But it's a matter of, if I'm a super optimistic, it's not the place to show my optimism in the valley. People will ask for more rational things there. They want the numbers. They want the rationale. And sometimes the rationale looks so beautiful. It's all makeup. But we just say, we believe. And they say, we proved by the numbers. At the end of the day, none of them know that. But they just think they do. So that's my provocation. Understand more who we are. Look to our Button Valley. Helps the ecosystem grow from a Gisele Bündchen with 12 to Gisele Bündchen in a few years. And thank you, you guys, and hope you enjoy this little talk.